content that I will follow. I will starting with the motivation, following with the problem statement, and then it will lead to the objective. After that, I will explain about the design, simulation, and experiment. And finally, I will conclude this work. So as we know that the future network have the higher requirement. To meet this higher requirement, the future networks must use the new technique or the new approach. Utilizing higher frequency is one of the techniques that offer faster data rate, wider bandwidth, lower latency, and greater user capacity. Now we are using millimeter wave band in 5G, and for 6G we are now considering to use the terahertz band. However, the higher frequency means shorter wavelength. The shorter wavelength will lead to this problem. These problems are considered to be the coverage area challenge. Recently, the anomalous defector have been developed. This defector have the potential to manipulate the direction of the defected wave. So compared with the traditional repeater, anomalous defector offer the compact structure, lower cost, and less energy consumption. So various of anomalous defector have been proposed. But if we talk about the high efficiency anomalous defector, we must consider this one and this one. The plastic defection is the defection in the direction that we don't want, which is this and this. And another one is the material losses, which mainly occur in the substrate layer. And especially for higher frequency, the material losses become worse. So this table summarizes the previous study or the previous work of the defector design. Some of them can suppress the plastic defection, some of them cannot. From this table, you can see that the research are now focusing on millimeter wave band, but for the terahertz band, there is no high efficiency defector. So it leads to this objective of this work. We are going to design the high efficiency anomalous defector to operate at 140 GHz. The defector will have the reflection angle at 30, 45, 60, and 75. It supports the terahertz communication and it has low material loss and simple structure. So these are the design workflow of this work. They're starting with the unit cell design. After that, they optimize the unit cell to form the reflector. And after that, they perform the simulation to see the S parameter and radar cross section. To verify the simulation result, they perform the experiment. Okay. Also, so these are the design of this reflector. They're choosing copper to be the metallic layer and choosing COP or cycloolefin polymer to be the substrate layer. And for the unit cell, they choose the rectangular patch, yeah, to be the resonator. After they optimize the unit cell here, they assemble the unit cell to form the reflector here. This figure shows the dimension of each reflector. For example, this one is the 30 degree anomalous reflector that will have this length here. Okay. And for the simulation setup, they starting with the boundary condition. The boundary condition, they just use only two conditions, which is the PEC perfect electric conductor, and another one is the open boundary, or PML. Yeah. And on top of the boundary condition, they have the excitation plane wave here. The plane wave have the linear Y polarization and have the frequency at 140 GHz. They use the frequency domain solver to calculate the S parameter and radar cross section. So this is the simulation result. Starting with the electric field distribution, you can see that this plane wave here, the plane wave, reflect at the direction here, which is corresponding to this angle. And for the radar cross section, you can see this one and this one are the parasitic reflection, which have been suppressed lower to this main reflection. And for this figure, is the frequency response of each reflector. We just focus only on this red line here, and at 140 GHz, you will see that they have the strong reflection at 140 GHz. For the experimental result, okay, they fabric this reflector here, they fabric here, and they put to the rotating stand here. In front of the stand, they have this one. It's a TX antenna, transmission antenna, and reflected antenna to measure the RCS of this reflector. And the IX antenna will move around this reflector. When the antenna move around, they can see this one. Okay. This one is a reflection, the reflection with the angle. Okay. From the reflection with angle, which is the radar cross section, the main reflection still remain. And for this one is a parasitic reflection, is suppressed. And for the frequency response of each reflector here, we just focus only on red line again. At 140 GHz, they have the storm reflection, which is consistent with this, the simulation result. So to conclude, they are successfully designed the perfect anomalous reflector. They perform both simulation and experimental measurement. And both simulation result and experimental result are consistent. And furthermore, this reflection not only offer the anomalous reflector, but also offer the suppression of the plastic reflection and low material loss. Thank you.
Thank you for the presentation. Do you have any questions?
Yes, actually the key of this work is this material, because in higher frequency we have the high material losses, right? So this COP cycloolefin polymer offer this relative permittivity and this loss tangent. This relative permittivity is quite low, so it offer less losses in the material. So this one is the key COP.
The yellow color.
The yellow color is the metallic part, which is the we can consider it as a resonator shape. It's a resonator here.
So for different type of reflector, the metallic shape varies. Right?
Yes, and also the number of the unit cell is different. For 30 degree, we have 10, and for the rest, we have maybe 8 and 6. It's different. They separately designed.
So, what are the advantages if we have more of the
unit cell.
Yeah, unit cell.
So if we have many unit cell, it offer the more accurate to steering the beam. And however, if we have a lot of unit cell, when we fabric, we will also have the high error, because if we have many unit cell, it becomes smaller, smaller, smaller. So it's hard to fabricate.
So it means that like angle 30 is more efficient?
Sorry?
Angle 30 is more efficient?
More efficient.
Yeah.
Actually, it's not more, we cannot say if this angle is more efficiency or not. It depends on our cost that we have to pay. For this one, I think maybe they think that okay, for 30 degree, they need more accuracy for this angle. So they add many unit cell for this angle. And for 60, maybe they don't want more.
Okay, thank you for the presentation.